My name is Charles Fox.
And I'm Warren Miller. And today we're going to be talking about the different types of inverters. When you install solar, your solar panels produce energy in direct current or DC current, and that has to be converted into alternating current or AC current that you use at your home or your business or your farm. And to do so, we use inverters.
That's exactly right, Warren. And there's three technologies that you should be aware of: a microinverter, an optimizer, and a string inverter. And so with a string inverter, Warren, just help them understand a little bit what that is and maybe the difference between that and a microinverter. Yeah.
So let's talk about string inverters and when those might make the most sense. You know, string inverters are typically the least expensive option. So if you're looking to increase your return on investment, they maybe make a lot of sense for you.
Yeah, they're also probably going to be the least efficient, though. So you have to weigh that. Yep, they're cheaper, but they're going to be less efficient. So not always is cheaper always better.
Correct. They're also not the ideal solution if you have any type of shading.
Right.
Because with string inverters, a single inverter will be managing an entire string of panels. And so if one panel has a little bit of shade on it, it's going to impact that entire string.
That's right, Warren. Great point. The other piece is the aesthetics to it. So you're going to have a box that's going to have to go on your wall somewhere, get mounted because of all the strings that are coming off the roof, versus a microinverter that's going to be attached probably to the back of a panel.
Correct.
All right, so let's go to microinverters, Warren.
Microinverters, from an aesthetic perspective, are probably the most aesthetically pleasing. The microinverter is a small inverter, micro, and it mounts underneath the panel, so you really don't see it.
And they're great for shade. So if you have a roof where it's shaded at different times throughout the day, what that means is that that one panel that's shaded does not affect the rest of the roof, the rest of those panels. Where if you have a string inverter, now because they're all tied together in a string, one panel shaded affects all the string. So that's a great solution for shade and a reason to go with the microinverter.
And the microinverters, in addition to that, Charles, they typically have longer warranties. They are more expensive. They're probably the most expensive of the three options, but they do come with a 25-year warranty for the most part. And they also allow you a more granular look. If you're looking at your solar array on your phone or your tablet or your computer, you'll be able to see what each solar panel is doing with the microinverter.
Yeah. And then the last type of technology is that optimizer, which we talked about. And that is kind of a hybrid approach between the microinverter and the string inverter, where you still will have that, your panels will be together in a string, but under each panel, or maybe two are tied together, there's going to be an optimizer, which allows you to get the same benefit that you would get off a microinverter, meaning that if there is shade, now the shaded panels are not going to affect the rest of the string.
Correct. And you would still have an inverter, a box that you would need to mount somewhere with the optimizer. So you would have essentially an inverter box mounted somewhere as well as an optimizer underneath the panel.
Right. So Warren, the $1 million question is, what did you do? You recently went solar. So what type of inverters do you have on your roof?
I did. And I chose to go with the micro inverters. I decided to pay the little additional cost and go with the longer warranty and have more of that granular look to be able to see exactly what my solar system is doing.
Yeah. So the differences between the three different types of inverters: cost, efficiency, and then shade. Those are the three big ones that you should be aware of as you're choosing an inverter. Thank you for watching. Hope you found this video helpful.